Excuse me, Tommy? Hey, I'm Greg.
Yeah, I see you in there.
I was just wondering if you maybe wanted to do a scene together.
You wanted this scene with me?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's up, everyone? I'm Caleb.
I'm Trevor.
And, fucking, typically when we've done a movie review on the channel, it's been on a podcast, but, we decided we were gonna try to do something different this time, and this is that thing. So, it's gonna hopefully be the standard for our movie reviews going into the future. The movie we are reviewing today is The Disaster Artist, which before going into this film, the whole premise of this film is that it's the making of another movie called The Room. Mm-hmm. Do you want to tell them what The Room is real quick?
The Room is this mysterious 2003 movie that came out, and it's widely considered like one of the worst movies ever made, but it's also considered like an amazing movie.
I would reckon it's been on the internet for a while. A lot of memes have stemmed from it.
You are tearing me apart, Lisa!
I did not hit her. It's not true. It's bullshit. I did not hit her. I did not. Oh, hi, Mark.
Main guy behind The Room is a very mysterious man. Yeah. Tommy Wiseau.
And it's crazy because he, like, we don't really know where he comes from. We don't know how he has all the money he does.
He funded the movie like $6 million from his own bank account.
It's crazy.
He's not a good actor, and the movie's told from the perspective of his friend Greg Sestero, who wrote the book The Disaster Artist that the film itself is based off of.
Yes. I haven't read the book.
I have not read the book either. Don't know if it's super faithful to the book. Mm-hmm. Or actually, I'm not how sure this is super faithful to events that have occurred. You know,
From what I understand, it's pretty faithful. Like a lot of this stuff really like as strange as it all is, a lot of it is just 100% honest.
A quick little overview of it. Yeah. The film, like we said, it's told from Tommy Wiseau's friend's perspective, Greg Sestero, and basically. Mm-hmm. Him discovering Tommy and becoming friends with him. Mm-hmm. And then they move to L.A. together.
Yes.
To become actors. Like, to pursue randomly. This dream. Strange. Literally, it's one night, you know, Tommy, like, and Greg, you know, they're getting drunk one night, and Tommy's just like, why don't we go to L.A., you know?
I don't want to like in the overview part of spoil it, but if you want to hear our full thoughts at the end of this video, after our overview,
basically,
we're going to go ahead and get into
LA. They get to LA, the acting career doesn't really pick up for either of them, so they decide if no one's going to give us a shot, we'll give ourselves a shot, and like we said, you know, Tommy funded the movie himself. Mm-hmm. Basically, and that's where, you know, and then, you know, that's where the rest of the Disaster Artist comes in. It's the making of that film. So that's the basic overview of it. Just quick thoughts and feelings of it. I loved it.
You know what they say, love is blind.
I loved it too, man. And it was way I loved it in a different way than I expected to.
I went into it thinking it was going to be a stupid, funny movie. What I was not expecting was a very heartfelt movie, which was very surprising.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was truly shocked. Like, I've always been a fan of James Franco as an actor, but he, in this movie, he really truly blew me away with a performance I never could have expected. Right, he played him so honestly and with such care and empathy. And Tommy is really almost an alien. Like when you see him in interviews, or if you see him, or even if you just see The Room, like that's just kind of how the dude actually is. You know, like he just isn't these like terrible acting. That's just how he actually is.
Much
as a human
of the
being.
Conflict in the entire movie just arises from people, you know,
not understanding him at
you
all.
You know, they're just. You know, they're dealing with these requests he keeps giving everyone that, you know, they're strange requests to everyone else, but to him they make perfect sense.
And in many ways, it is hilarious. It's so mm-hmm. funny.
That's where a lot of the humor mm-hmm. comes from. Yeah. It's just, you know, that, like,
and
that
the strangeness.
Oddity.
Yeah, the strangeness of Tommy himself. And I have to say, James Franco gives one of the best performances I've seen in a really long time in this movie. Shout out to Dave Franco, too.
Oh, yeah. His brother, James Franco's brother, Dave Franco, plays the character of Greg.
Perfect.
And they have the chemistry on it's screen there. Together. Mm-hmm. Most of the actors on screen have wonderful chemistry
it's
together
really,
during this movie. Josh Hutcherson is in this movie.
I love a few of the random cameos in this movie. Like, there's...
Burris.
Yeah, and they just show up like just out of nowhere, and they're like part
Zac
of making
Efron.
The film.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think there's even a few more in there. I think Brie Larson's also in there, which is I'm a big not Brie Larson, not Brie Larson. Who's it? What's it? Oh no, it's she's a great actress.
I got no idea.
I think it's like Brie something. But anyway, she's great too. Everyone in the movie like plays their parts perfectly. Seth Rogen, all of the people that are generally in their movies are in this one, and it really takes a different turn than a lot of Seth Rogen and James Franco movies, in that it is much more serious and much more touching.
And I think, you know, I honestly, you know, if you're kind of going in there, you know, expecting typical James Franco, Seth Rogen humor, you really honestly aren't going to find that. But, you know, that's not always a bad thing.
I think this
proves that they're a lot more capable than, you know, just James Franco and Seth Rogen stuff.
Yeah.
I genuinely love the stuff they do together.
Yeah, because most of that, I mean, truly, like, a lot of their comedies are, like, my favorite comedies of this generation. Everything they come out with, every once in a while there's something stupid, but it's great. A lot of it has been in the same lane. Mm-hmm. But this one really, for me, switched lanes and showed that they have much more range than we thought they
did. At least one viewing, you know, like, mm-hmm. like in the theater, mm-hmm. for me, is what I would suggest.
Absolutely, me too. I'd say see it as soon as possible, because it truly is, it's an incredible film.
So that kind of wraps up the basic review of that. So now we're going to kind of go into a more in-depth discussion of it. Mm-hmm. There will be spoilers, mm-hmm. like more heavier spoilers, I guess I should say. So
in this one.
If you just want to save everything for, you know, fresh, then you probably should not have clicked this video actually in the first place.
Yeah.
But get out of here. Mm-hmm. So one of my favorite just things overall in general, is just how James Franco plays Tommy Wiseau in this movie.
I really feel like it's one of the better performances I've seen in a very long time.
I really get the feeling that all, like, because, like, Tommy's, like, is just a dick to everybody, but, like, just the way he plays him, like, I truly believe that he doesn't think he's being a dick. He thinks he's helping everyone. Mm-hmm. He's, like, he and Greg get, like, into an argument on set one day because he's being a dick to the other actors. He's like, I give them salary, I give them jobs, they're not grateful, mm-hmm. you know?
Nobody respect my vision. Yeah, it's...
And, you know, like, everyone, you know, kind of talks bad about him behind mm-hmm. his back because, you know, he's being a dick and he's also, you know, he's being weird.
A little bit of a goofball.
Yeah, and, you know, they're not understanding him. Like, really, Greg's the only one who can communicate with Tommy, almost.
Yeah, the rest of them just, like, are these, like, distant creatures.
But it gets to the point where he pushes Greg away, too, because he believes, you know, Greg owes him, like, everything, you know, and everything, and he, like, keeps forcing Greg to quit, like, he costs him that role on Malcolm in the Middle.
Yeah, which would have been really good for him.
Would have been really good exposure.
And because of that, he ends up losing his girlfriend, too, like, mm-hmm. because he didn't...
stand up to Tommy, basically.
Yeah, he lost, like, and it was over something he could have, you know...
It's not till the end, though, that, like, when you see, like, you know, like, they, after making, the room gets made and everything after much difficulty on set with Tommy and everyone, and, at the premiere, you know, Tommy truly thinks he's making a masterpiece of film, and when it's finally showed on the screen, you know, he's expecting everyone else to see the same thing, and then he finally realizes that not everyone else sees
things
what
as he does.
Yes, as he does. And he just breaks down over it, and I kind
of and
like,
James
you know,
Franco's performance of all of that, it's amazing. Like it really, like the fact James Franco's a very recognizable person. I completely forgot he was in this movie. It felt like it was just Tommy on screen as Tommy. There's
I always thought James Franco's face, but I was just amazed that at the voice and everything.
I felt the Tommy spirit was coming out. Yeah, I still could see James Franco there, but like it was that his Tommy spirit completely overwhelmed the face of James Franco. I watched an interview with Seth Rogen over like why James decided to make this movie and make it the way that he did, which with so much empathy towards Tommy. And Seth responded by saying that James truly feels like a real connection with Tommy because James understands what it's like to be him, to think that you're making something amazing and cool, like, and to see all the art and amazingness in all of everything you've done. James Franco's done a lot of things like this. He has made a lot of films that people just didn't get. His passion projects are not a lot of times like the comedy ones. He likes doing those are fun. But it's all the little independent films that he makes that he wants people to come
that,
out
to
see.
That, you know, explains a lot.
Exactly. Yeah. And so he knows what it's like to make something that he finds powerful and beautiful and have people completely reject it. And it's a really hard thing for him to go through. So in seeing Tommy Wiseau put his whole life and love and money into this thing and to see it fail so spectacularly, he really feels a lot of deep connection to him. And that's why he decided to take on this movie and do it the way he did, to play with your empathy, to make you truly empathize with someone that seemed unempathizable.
And they it really is hard to empathize with Tommy sometimes, just because
because he's kind of a dick.
Really, straight up, he traps him in a fucking hot. He's late to work on set every day for his own movie. There's a day that, it's, like, super hot outside, and fucking, he just, he shows up 4 hours late, and they're all like, we are dying in here, man, you gotta get, he doesn't pay for air conditioning in the building, and he's like, you gotta, let us open a door, you gotta, get us some water, you gotta do something, and he's like, no, you can't do that.
And yeah, just, yeah, there's a lot of and we already talked about the Malcolm in the Middle thing, but that's such a dick move. Yeah, let's move on to Dave Franco.
Yeah, I gave him a shout out earlier, but he does a really good job as Greg Sestero, and I just love, he knows Tommy is bad for his image. And you can see him, just that struggle in him.
Nice fucking guy.
He truly believes that he came here with Tommy. He's gonna do this with him, you know? Tommy's been here for me. Tommy believed in me, I gotta be there for him. And just as things go downhill, as Tommy keeps making these more and more absurd requests, you could just see the strain on it's taken on Greg. Like, he was like, do I keep being friends with this guy, or do I,
It's rough.
And
Dave really does bring, a real... He really captures what it's like to be... To probably be Greg Sestero. Because, Greg Sestero's not completely a lack of strangeness either. His performance in The Room is just as wooden.
People are very strange these days. I used to know a girl. She had a dozen guys. One of them found out about it, beat her up so bad she ended up in a hospital on Guerrero Street.
Just as strange. Not just as strange.
I would say...
Hospital on Guerrero Street.
What a story, Mark.
I wouldn't say just...
But, very wooden, very strange, and... I don't know. And he ultimately was just as participatory on this whole thing as Tommy was. So... You needed that touch of strangeness, and Dave Franco really brought that extra level of something underneath the eyes of him. But then he also brought out the fact that Greg is just the nicest dude.
Cracked me up.
Who?
Throughout this entire fucking movie.
Who?
Josh Hutcherson.
Oh my god!
Every time I saw him as playing the character of Denny
The Room.
It fucking cracked my shit up. Jesus Christ.
I couldn't have picked a more perfect choice.
Oh, the scene where, he was fucking, being, where Zac Efron was fucking the drug dealer and fucking putting the gun on him and shit, and, he was on the ground and shit and was actually freaking out,
Yeah.
Oh, my
when he pulls him up, he's like... That's so, it's so, what a perfect choice, because Josh Hutcherson is that. He does that kind of look face. A little baby face,
yeah.
But you can tell that he's like probably like 25.
Yes.
Denny's the same way. If you go back and watch The Room, Denny looks like he's like 25, and he is 25. But he like he's trying to play like a 15-year-old. Oh my god! And it's just so, and in the hairstyle of it just makes it so much worse.
Oh man, we are at 15 minutes here, so.
Oh man.
I guess.
Let's go in and let's talk about just overall, like what our favorite parts were.
My favorite part.
No, least favorite if we have.
You know what? I think. It was a pretty solid movie.
Yeah.
Throughout, the best part for me was honestly just the making of The Room.
Yeah.
Oh
my god, it's so ridiculous.
I will say like nothing really too like interesting happens up to that point.
It's a good movie,
but that first kind of like half hour of it where they're setting up them going to LA and everything that. Drug on a little bit for me, but I understand why it was put in there, because you need this isn't just about the making of The Room, it's also about the relationship of Tommy and Greg, how they met.
Yeah, and if you don't have that, you don't have that connection to the character. Mm-hmm. When it does get there, so
I also believe you should like at least see something about The Room. You need to know this stuff about The Room,
at least read
before,
about it.
Least read about it.
I would recommend just watching it, 'cause it's fucking hilarious. But my favorite part, my favorite part is just James Franco as James Franco's role in this, because he wasn't just the actor, he also directed this film, and that he did a tremendous job putting this movie together. And what's even better is that he did it as he method acted this one, so he went full into Tommy Wiseau. So when he's directing the movie, he's directing it as Tommy Wiseau as well. So like behind he'd come on behind and be like, all right, the movie, like all right, the action, and he'd run back in front of the camera or whatever and do the whole thing as Tommy Wiseau. So, and just knowing that and watching how good of a performance he ended up giving, despite it also being him directing it, really, really impressed me. And it really showed me the range of James Franco and showed me that his talent is kind of, like, endless. He can do a lot of shit.
Fuck.
So, yeah. And then the only part that I didn't really like would be, like, it's hard to say that I didn't really, like, that I didn't like anything, because it was all pretty freaking amazing. I'd say probably the only thing I can think of is essentially, I mean, we're pretty much going the same route here, is that.
That beginning part?
No. Yeah, that's it. I mean, even that, I still enjoyed that part.
Yeah,
it was just a little
like
slow.
I said, I enjoyed it. It was just a little slow.
Yeah.
But it definitely picks up when they get to, the actual making
definitely.
Of Room. So, I guess...
Ultimately,
both say we definitely recommend.
Absolutely,
you go out and watch this film. Mm-hmm. Also, definitely recommend The Room, and I hope you guys like this style of format.
Hope you guys do.
I guess without further ado, peace out.
Peace to the world, friends.